Jackie and Trisha's grandma had come from Spain when she was a little girl. She was a superstitious woman with dozens of scary stories from her homeland, meant to keep the children in line. As children, she would tell the stories to the girls over and over again until they could recite them word for word. One story that had always stuck with them was the story of Lorenza Caprillo. Lorenza was the eldest of two children born to a wealthy merchant. Her brother Alonzo had always bumped heads with their father, leaving Lorenza to be their father's favorite. She was so favored that her father did something unheard of during the late 1800s. He left his estate to his daughter. Usually the son would be the heir of his father's fortune, but Alonzo was cut off. But Alonzo was a selfish man who wouldn't take being pushed aside without a fight. The day of his father's death, Alonzo arrived with medical professionals and claimed that his sister suffered from hysteria. Lorenza had been furious at the allegation, but that only made the doctors believe Alonzo more. She desperately told them that she was the right heir to their father's estate, and this was obviously a plan to get rid of her by Alonzo. The doctors didn't listen. They didn't look at the will. After all, who would choose to leave their estate to their daughter over their son? Lorenza was forcibly carted off to the closest asylum, where she lived until her death. The asylum was overcrowded and filthy. There was not enough food to adequately feed all the patients held in its walls. Lorenza ultimately died from starvation. Alonzo took control of his father's estate and swiftly ran it into the ground. He was a gambling man, and he had lost far too many times. No one knows what happened to him. Some say he lived a long life, while others claim that he was found dead in the street soon after losing the estate. Regardless, he had committed an act of great evil by betraying Lorenza. It is said that the spirit of Lorenza Caprillo could not rest due to the betrayal she suffered by her own flesh and blood. The legend goes that she roams the earth in a permanent state of hunger, ready to strike down anyone who betrays their flesh and blood. To summon her, one must cook a large feast as an offering to the spirit and say the following words: "Sweet Lady Lorenza, feel my sorrow. My blood has stolen my promised tomorrow. Sweet Lady, oh please, hear my cry, and let my treacherous blood out to die." The story was a warning to never betray your family. Unfortunately, some would ignore this warning. Jackie had fallen in love with a handsome man named Marcus. They were engaged to be married, and Jackie was in a state of bliss. But the day of the wedding, Marcus didn't show up. He wasn't the only person missing from the ceremony. Jackie's own sister, Trisha, was also gone. The two had run away together, later marrying and beginning a family on their own. Jackie was heartbroken. Jackie was betrayed. Jackie was vengeful. Her pain turned to hatred, and she recalled the legend of Lorenza Caprillo. She didn't even fully believe the legend, but she was desperate to make her sister pay for the pain she had caused. She made a feast of turkey, potatoes, and pies, among other things. She set up a table in her backyard and put all the food out in a spread. It looked like it was a Thanksgiving, though Jackie was feeling anything but thankful. She spoke the words to summon the spirit of Lorenza Caprillo. She hoped for an apparition of a great wind, anything to show that it had worked. Nothing. She felt foolish but left the food outside on a tiny glimmer of hope that the legend could be true and she had been successful. She went to bed feeling like an idiot. She was awoken to the sound of her phone ringing around 4 in the morning. Half awake, she stumbled out of bed and picked it up. Crying was heard on the other end. It was her mother saying that Trisha had an unexpected heart attack the night before. She was dead. Jackie comforted her mother and promised to meet her at her house. She hung up the phone and ran outside. All of the food was gone. She did it. She had successfully summoned Lorenza Caprillo. She was overjoyed as she ran back into the house. She got dressed and drove to her mother's house. She put on a sad face and greeted her family. People were crying and holding on to one another. It took everything Jackie had not to let out a giggle. Payback felt amazing. She spent the rest of the day at the house before heading to home and getting ready for bed. She needed her rest. After all, There were a lot of funeral plans she would be helping with over the next week. She danced around her room, spinning in circles, laughing loudly. The euphoria danced in her veins as she began humming a tuneless beat. Her joy was short-lived. Jackie was spinning when the reflection in the mirror caught her eye. She stopped in shock and stared in horror, frozen to the spot. Behind her was a woman with a dirty face and scraggly hair. She was emaciated and was wearing a tattered dress. Her eyes were filled with fury. Lorenza Caprillo. But why did she look so mad at Jackie? She had been the one who summoned her. Lorenza slowly raised her stick like an arm and pointed at Jackie. You had me kill your sister. You betrayed your own flesh and blood, she said in a raspy voice. Jackie realized her mistake as she spun around. The last thing she remembered was the pain in her chest before darkness swallowed her whole.